On a gloomy and rainy day, 4th Street Live welcomed this group of people. Many are from different countries and backgrounds, but they all have one thing in common. After a long process of applications and interviews, they're finally becoming U.S. citizens.
Been waiting for this moment for so long that I almost started crying because I was so emotional.
Iroda Ergasheva is from Kurdistan and has been in the U.S. for just over a year. She's a member of the U.S. Army and says this final step is one that makes her forever grateful to call this country her home.
To me, the most important thing was that we do not support any kind of behavior against a certain race, gender, or sexual orientation, that we just fight for rights of people, for their rights to live, to be free, and to just be happy.
Over a dozen service members swore their allegiance to America today, just 3 days before Independence Day, some even with tears in their eyes. Rosalyn Almanzar Tejada tells me she came to America at the age of 6, moving to New York City from the Dominican Republic. She now serves this country and drove 3 hours from Fort Campbell, where she's based, to be here. It was something she says she'd never miss.
I've been fighting for this for so long, and it's like I finally got it, so it feels amazing.
She's now a proud member of not only the military, but a citizen of the country she serves. It's a pride she shares with other service members here, too, an honor that brings a lot of meaning.
To me, being here and becoming a citizen of the United States of America means being a citizen of a country that is for equality, that is a country of opportunities, that stands its ground.
Equality and opportunity, what all of these new U.S. citizens see when they look at the American flag. In downtown Louisville, Gladys Bautista, WLKY News.